are separated by a distance L. When A starts from X with a speed of 4 km per hour, he reaches 5 minutes late from his usual time. When he starts with a speed 6 km per hour, he reaches 7 minutes early. This is the given information. You need to find out the length of this journey x to y. Alright, we will solve this question using multi-cap pedagogy. I'll first explain the traditional method and then the train method. Alright, so length can be written as distance is equal to speed into time. 4 kilometers per hour, time will be t, since he was 5 minutes late, plus 5 by 16. In the next case, 6 into t minus 7 by 60, because he was 7 minutes early, right? Now, equating these two, 4t plus 1 by 3 is equal to 60 minus 7 by 10. Alright? So, what you get here is 2t is equal to 1 by 3 plus 7 by 10. So, I am solving this now. So, you get the value of t. Alright? Now, put the value of t here to get the length. So, L is equal to 4 into, putting t here, kilometers. Alright, so this is the traditional method where you form equations and solve the equations to get the answer. Alright, now let's try to move towards the sharper method. Let's make time constant. See, this is a very nice method for solving such questions. If time is constant, distance is proportional to speed, or v1 by v2 is equal to s1 by s2. Now, this is the basic THD concept, time, speed, distance. Whenever we study, we go through this concept, right? So, in constant time, let's say original time t, how much distance would A have covered? A would have covered L minus 4 into 5 by 60. And in the same time t, A would have covered L plus 6 into 7 by 60. And this length in original time is equal to the ratio of speeds 4 by 6. So this is equal to 2 by 3. Single equation, the question gets solved. Got the logic? So what do we get here? L minus 1 by 3 divided by L plus 7 by 10 is equal to 2 by 3. Solving further, 3L minus 1 is equal to 2L plus 7 by 5, or L is equal to 1 plus 7 by 5, which is equal to 2.4 kilometers. Got the logic? Let me explain this once again. In the original time t, the constant time is t, the time for the journey, how much distance would each have covered? That will give the distance ratio. That can be equated to the speed ratio, because when time is constant, distance is proportional to speed. Alright? So, in original time t, In the first case, L minus 4 into this much because he was late, so he would have covered this much less. In the second case, he was early, so if we take the full time, he will cover this much extra. Right? So, distance ratio is equal to speed ratio, and you get to the solution faster than the traditional method. I hope the concept is clear. Thank you.